Only fire when I tell you to fire.
I'm sorry.
I'm sorry. I am dead.
R301 is the best all-around weapon in Apex Legends. You need to know how to use it. How to get the most out of it? Watch this video to learn everything you need to know. Hey guys, I hope you're having a great day. I really love the flexibility and reliability of the R301. I think you should run it almost always when you get the chance. I'm going to go over its recoil pattern, its damage output, and the best situations to use it in. I'll give you a bunch of other tips and tricks to get the most out of the gun. Each weapon in Apex Legends has a set recoil pattern. If you learn the pattern, you can mostly counter it with your mouse or controller. This is the R301's recoil pattern. It goes up and slightly to the right, then it curves back left. It looks a bit like a question mark. In order to manage it, make sure to move your mouse or controller stick down and slightly to the left. The end of the pattern is pretty much impossible to manage in a real fight at range. Your best option is to burst fire 8 to 12 bullets at a time. Recoil resets extremely fast in Apex. Burst fire will allow you to only deal with the first half of the recoil pattern, which is much easier to manage. The R301 deals 14 damage per body shot and 11 damage per leg shot. It deals 25 damage per headshot, but this can go all the way down to 19 if an opponent has a helmet of level 3 or 4. This is why it's best to aim for your opponent's upper body. This will give you a reliable 14 damage per shot. It will also allow you to get the occasional headshot even if you fail to control the recoil pattern. You only need to hit 16 shots in order to down an opponent with a level 5 red evo armor. This is doable even without an extended magazine of any kind. You even have 2 shots to spare. Let's go over the attachments really fast. The extended magazine is the most important one. Prioritize it if you have to choose. The additional ammo capacity will provide you with the space to miss more shots and still one clip every opponent. The standard stock will make the gun better at fighting at hip fire range as you will go in and out of aiming down sight much faster. Any level of barrel stabilizer will make the R301 a laser at medium and long range. The most preferred optic attachment by most top players is the 2X Bruiser. The 1X Classic and Holo, as well as the Variable Holo, are also pretty good and reliable options. To be fair, the 301 has one of the best iron sights in the game, so don't be afraid to use it in a pinch. Some people prefer the 3X Ranger, but I find the optimal range for it is slightly longer than the optimal range for fighting with the R301, so I don't really use it that much. This weapon is surprisingly competitive at hipfire range of up to 15 meters. The recoil is much more random, but it's definitely manageable. The R301 has a 50% speed penalty on your movement while you're aiming down sights, just like every other assault rifle. In a close quarters fight, it's really best to use cover and hipfire. This will allow you to move freely and remain a hard target for anyone pushing you with a shotgun or an SMG. Let's have a word about the anvil receiver. This attachment increases your single fire shots up to 35 damage to the body and 32 damage to the legs. The headshot is worth between 61 and 46 damage depending on the level of the helmet the enemy is wearing. This, combined with the lower ADS movement penalty, makes the R301 a straight up better version of the G7 Scout. Usually, I only poke long range to finish leveling an armor or to steal a kill off a fight. However, if you do enjoy that playstyle, I believe the 301 along with the flatline equipped with an anvil receiver is what you should be getting. They both provide the best and most flexible long range weapon without giving up value on medium and short range. If you do run the anvil receiver and use it, consider running the X3 Ranger optics for the best results. The best gun for your other slot should cover the R301's weak spots. The R301 is worst at extremely long range and extremely close range. The close range fights tend to come up a lot more often in Apex Legends. This means it's best to carry an EVA 8 Volt SMG or an R99 as your secondary weapon. They all have higher DPS output compared to the R301. Do your best to avoid situations that are pure aim duo while you have the R301 equipped. If your opponent has equal or better aiming ability and is rocking a shotgun or an SMG, you will probably lose. Do your best to force the fights at your optimal range. For the R301, this is anywhere between 30 and 70 meters. Don't forget to head glitch whenever possible. Do it from cover or from high ground as much as you can. If you have any additional questions on the R301 or anything else Apex related, ask me in the comments. If you find this video useful, please like it and share it with one of your friends.